and sisters, to prepare our hearts to enter into the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. I confess before my mighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which consisted of men, women, and those children old enough to understand. Standing at one end of the open place that was before the water gate, he read out of the book from daybreak till midday, in the presence of the men, the women, and those children old enough to understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra the scribe stood on a wooden platform that had been made for the occasion. He opened the scroll so that all the people might see it, for he was standing higher up than any of the people. And as he opened it, all the people rose. Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people, their hands raised high, answered, "Amen, amen." Then they bowed down and prostrated themselves before the Lord, their faces to the ground. Ezra read plainly from the book of the law of God, interpreting it so that all could understand what was read. Then Nehemiah, that is, his excellency, and Ezra the priest scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to all the people, "Today is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad, and do not weep." For all the people were weeping as he heard the words of the law. He said further, "Go, eat rich foods and drink sweet drinks, and allot portions to those who had nothing prepared. for today is holy to our Lord. Do not be sad in this day, for rejoicing in the Lord must be your strength. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For in one spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one spirit. Now the body is not a single part, but many. If a foot should say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, it does not for this reason belong any less to the body. Or if an ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body. It does not for this reason belong any less to the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would the hearing be? If the whole body were hearing, where would the sense of smell be? But as it is, God placed the parts, each one of them, in the body as he intended. If they were all one part, where would the body be? But as it is, there are many parts, yet one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I do not need you. Nor again, the head to the feet, I do not need you. Indeed, the parts of the body that seem to be weaker are all the more necessary. And those parts of the body that we consider less honorable, we surround with greater honor. And our less presentable parts are treated with greater propriety. Whereas our most presentable parts do not need this. But God has so constructed the body as to give greater honor to a part that is without it, so that there may be no division in the body, but that the parts may have the same concern for one another. If one part suffers, all the parts suffer with it. If one part is honored, all the parts share its glory. Now you are Christ's body, and individually parts of it. Some people God has designated in the church to be second, prophets, third, teachers, then mighty deeds, then gifts of healing, assistance, administration, and varieties of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work mighty deeds? Do all have gifts of healing? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Since many have undertaken to compile a narrative of the events that have been fulfilled among us, just as those who are eyewitnesses from the beginning and ministers of the word have handed them down to us, I too have decided, after investigating everything accurately anew, to write it down in orderly sequence for you, most excellent Theophilus, so that you may realize the certainty of the teachings you have received. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read, and it was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, that last line of the Gospel is key for our reflection today. Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing. Today, the scripture passage is written. That's important because we must understand that when the word of God is proclaimed, it is proclaimed today. The Lord, opening up the scroll from the prophet Isaiah, recites, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor."
It is proclaimed today. And it is important for us to understand that we, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Spirit of our Lord is upon each of us, and that we are anointed. Baptism, we're anointed. Confirmation, we're anointed. And Holy Orders, I was anointed. Many of us have been anointed as we prepare for surgery, while we prepare to meet the Lord in glory in the anointing of the sick. We are anointed, and we too are called, like our Lord, to bring glad tidings to the poor. Now, in this particular passage, it is the Lord speaking to them. One of their own is speaking to them. The eyes of all were intent, looking intently at him. We're reminded in the second reading from the letter of St. Paul to the people of Corinth that we all have unique gifts, but we are all part of the one body of Christ. We are led by the one Spirit. Says some people God has designated the church to be apostles, others prophets, their teachers, then mighty beings. We all have been given different and unique gifts. And so we go back to last week, my dear brothers and sisters. As the Blessed Mother said to those attendants, do whatever he tells you. We must allow ourselves to be moved by the one Spirit. We must unite ourselves to Christ. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, in the words of the responsorial Psalms, Lord, your words, Lord, are spirit and life. Life. The Word of God is alive. And when it's proclaimed, it's not something of the past, but it speaks to us here and now. And when we listen to the Scriptures, as we read the Scriptures, it is important that we take it to prayer and apply it to our lives today. Yes, certainly this happened 2,000 years ago, but as it is proclaimed, Jesus says, today. So every time the Scripture is proclaimed, it is today. It is living, it is effective, and that we are called to follow and look intently at our Lord and follow the example and the direction he gives us so that we can remain in the one body, the one Spirit. And that's our goal today, to utilize the gifts that we have been given. We all have different gifts, my dear brothers and sisters. We're all part of the same body of Christ. And the Spirit of the Lord is upon all of us. And he has anointed us. Because he loves us, he has anointed us. And he wants us to go out into the world to bring glad tidings to others, to proclaim liberty to captives, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, today, carpe diem, seize the day, today. God is speaking to us today. And whatever he's saying to us, listen to his voice. Follow the example he's given us. And allow ourselves to go out. You've heard the word of God today. And as we're strengthened by his words, but in his own body, blood, soul, divinity, we're called to go out and to glorify the Lord by our lives, to go and announce the gospel of the Lord, whichever ending I decide to say. It's one of the options. Either go and announce the gospel of the Lord, go in peace, glorify the Lord by your lives. We're called to go out and to live our faith today. Not tomorrow, not yesterday, but today.
Thank you.
the Lord's name be accepted with the God, the Almighty God.
And for the Lord's soul, set the house of God's church. Praise his Lord, his name, for our good and all souls of the church.
Accept our offerings, Lord, we pray, and sanctify them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know that it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy of immortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs, the one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
Thank you.
church, and graciously grant your peace and unity according to your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
pray, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us new life, we may always glory in your gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for just a moment. Order forms are in the back of the Knights of Columbus subsail. Also, there is a sign-up sheet in the back if you missed your pictures for Monday, February 7th, which is our makeup day. If you missed your appointment because of illness or weather, please sign up. Our director will not be complete without you. Also, there is a sign-up sheet in the back if you do not have a computer and need to come to the church for your Zoom appointment. There are some times in the back. I have listed that. There's another sheet of church Zoom appointments. So that's the second sheet with different times and the dates are back there. So sign up for one of those dates and we'll schedule that appointment. There will be no confessions and no public mass for Monday through Wednesday. Originally, I was supposed to be available for to give this to in order to be a witness in a trial in York. And unfortunately, I got a call yesterday that they canceled because one of the attorneys has COVID, so they postponed it to March. However, rather than trying to rearrange the schedule, I'm going to take it as a gift from God and I'm going to rest. Because I have to admit, you know, I told you that I was going to use Monday of last week as my Sabbath. Well, not quite. I was out for 3 hours shoveling snow, so not quite. So Monday through Wednesday, I'm going to use it as a rest day. And of course, tonight's we'll have the sub-sale information back there. But one of the things I do want to touch upon is I announced last week the sale of the convent has been complete. It took us a little bit to get there because there were some things we needed to work out. But as I mentioned, the convent was sold to Ayala Rentals, who intends to use the building for apartments and office and retail space. And one of the things we worked out, originally he wanted the parking behind the convent, but an issue came up that needed to be addressed. And we looked at a couple different options, but we settled on an option that would benefit both the buyer of the convent and us as a parish. And that is the parking lot, which we own. I want to clarify that we own that parking lot. What we are going to do is enlarge that lot. So it's going to move from 16 spaces, which is over there right now, to 31. However, six of them will be reserved specifically for the apartments. And so they'll be reserved for the apartments 7 days a week, 365 days a year, 24 hours a day. But that gains us 9 parking spots, which is huge for us. And so that is a help. And so that will begin at some point late spring, early summer. And how we came up with that is we are splitting the cost with the buyer 50-50. And as far as our part for that, we just simply lowered the sale price, which brought us to the sale price of $174,122. And so, beginning the spring and summer, we will start the process of enlarging the lot, which will benefit us because more people are coming to church. More people are coming to turkey dinners, another record breaking we did last weekend. 486 meals sold. That is awesome. I actually got the Mayday at 12:15, and the children didn't run out. So I went over and said a blessing, and miraculously we ended up praying. Thank you, God. I did that once before for the greeting. But there's a lot of good things happening. And with the turkey dinner, and I also gave an update on the sound system, we just have to be patient. We're just waiting for install right now. But we got the wires run that we need to run, so we're just waiting patiently. That's been paid for, so very good job, everyone. And I thank you again for your generosity and support. And with that, please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the archangel, bless us in this battle. May God bless you.